large work on the building being done to meet the 40-year standard. That is something that has been put in place, not just for the county, but for all municipalities. And we have a strict building code since Hurricane Andrew for updates and improvements.
Underground, everything exploded down at 8777 Collins.
Miami, this is Miami Beach with a transfer. Sir, if you're on 88th Street in Collins Avenue, you get down at 877 Collins.
Holy shit!
Miami Beach.
What? Yeah, hold on.
8777 Collins Avenue. Hello.
You need to speak with the operator.
Hello.
Oh my God.
Ma'am, the operator is
asking
if anyone is injured.
Oh my God.
That's okay. Wait.
Wow.
Oh my God.
Oh
my God.
Oh my
God.
People will recover from the rubble on the June 24th tragedy. All but two of those victims have been identified. Meanwhile, another hearing is underway over the sale of the site.
And Local 10 News reporter Madeline Wright is live from Miami with what's happening in court there. Madeline.
Christy, Janice, the hearing was about 2 hours long, and for the first time, we're hearing directly from condo owners themselves about how they want the land to be used. Take a look at this video. Several condo owners stood before the judge this morning to convince him to let developers build a new condo building on the site of Champlain Towers South because they want to keep living there. Condo owners, however, are divided on what to do with the land, which is worth an estimated $100 million. Some want a memorial on the site to honor the victims. Others say the two options are not mutually exclusive, that you can have a new condo building there and a memorial. Right now, the judge is strongly considering having the land sold so that the money can be used to pay compensation to the survivors who lost their homes, as well as family members of people who were killed or injured. Orin Citrinbaum bought a condo unit at Champlain Towers South years ago because it was spacious and right on the ocean.
It's an opportunity to live in an area like that that doesn't come around very often, and to replace it now for a lot of these owners will be almost mission impossible considering that where home prices are, especially beachfront property. I mean, that was taken away from a lot of people, and that's why a lot of people feel they would like their home back.
Sky 10 shows how different the collapsed site looks now that the rubble has been cleared out. None of the debris, however, will be thrown out. Some of it's being saved in a warehouse as evidence for the investigation into how the building collapsed. The rest is being stored in a lot so that survivors and families can go through it at a later date to retrieve their belongings. Now, back live at the courthouse, the purpose of today's hearing was for the judge to get an update on the process of compensating the victims for their enormous losses. The court-appointed receiver says that the condo board had about $1 million cash on hand. Also, there are about $50 million in insurance proceeds that are available for compensation. About $2 million have already been paid out to the victims. Live in Miami, Madeline Wright, Local 10 News.
Is where Champlain Towers South once stood.
After nearly 4 weeks, crews have removed nearly all of the debris, clearing the rubble right down to the walls of the parking garage. The cars that were in that underground garage have been moved to an undisclosed location right along with the rubble while investigators try to figure out what caused the collapse. Crews have cleared more than 22 million pounds of debris from that site.
And officials are now identifying two additional victims in the collapse. Authorities say they've recovered the body of 24-year-old Anastasia Gromova just this past Sunday. Now, she had been accepted into a program teaching English to students in Japan, and her trip here to Florida was supposed to be one last vacation before she started that program. Officials also now identifying 58-year-old Linda March. Her body recovered July 5th. She had recently moved back from New York to Surfside. So far, 97 bodies recovered in total. Miami-Dade County officials say there is believed to be just one victim not identified.